हम इस साल में हम ही अच्छे हम ही रहेंगे ये लोग आते हैं
अभी अंदर सेटअप कर लो प्लीज मनोज
कांग्रेस जीबीएफ
न्यू
सैड ना सालों की मेहनत के बाद आई देखो यही बन चुकी है आज फैशन वर्ल्ड
और सब लगते थे कि टाका क्या है
किसी ने बोला
sitting, we can't stand and talk.
Sit. No, you can just sit.
We can't stand.
Of course you sit.
Hi, how are you? I'm not demanding like that. There's a brand called Gazelle.
Am I demanding?
Yeah, you're picking. Much more than any of us.
Manoj, kya Manoj?
Yeah, why?
Bus.
If Hero and Karan are
there, I don't come to the shows if I don't walk in or I'm not gonna. I stopped.
I don't know the manager was different from this, but I understand.
There was a relationship.
That's funny. I thought you were a victim of all changes.
See, your personal show or no? But for Shabana's legacy, I'm not. I don't know, tell her.
Haan, ek second. Kya hua? Kuch nahi.
Up here on the dais, let's have a round of applause, please. A very good evening, gentlemen. May I please request Mr. Jitesh Pillai to say a few words? Thank you.
Does this work? Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being here. First of all, at the risk of getting ahead of myself, I must say we had a terrific Glamour and Style Awards. Thanks to Ciroc for their partnership, and it is the start of many interesting things to come. Two people on this podium mean a lot to me. They have sort of epitomized fashion and style in the movies. Manish Malhotra came at a time when the fashion didn't get its prominence in the movies. There was a dumbing down, and he really revolutionized the way we look at fashion, the way we look at glamour with his forays into the movie business. Ditto Karan, who I think knows desires to be a fashion designer and do his little bit. He came into the movies with being an assistant to Aditya, as you all know, and made a movie which changed all of our lives. Particularly interesting in the movie was the kind of fashion savvy a filmmaker shown, which was very rare for someone his age. So it's only fitting that Karan and Manish have graced our event today. So thank you once again. why the Glamour and Style Awards? We've celebrated excellence in the movies for a long time. We realized down the years, movie stars have constantly been synonymous with fashion and style. Like if you see in Hollywood, whether you had Audrey Hepburn or you had Sophia Loren, a lot of cross-pollination between the fashion business and the movie business was evident. And Filmfare thought it was the right time to tap into a space. I mean, here you have film stars on the covers of car magazines, health magazines, women's magazines, fashion magazines. So it just seemed right for Filmfare to be at the fashion, glamour, and style scene. So thank you, gentlemen. And without much ado, I shall pass the mic on to Bhavesh.
Thanks, Jitesh, and very kind of you. Couldn't agree more. I think I was absolutely blown by the event and the start of this wonderful journey of this association of Siroc with the Filmfare Style and Glamour Awards. Honestly, I think it is, as I said earlier in the event that we had, I believe this property will become one of the foremost icons of style and sophistications, very similar to the three gentlemen I'm sharing the stage with today and I had the good fortune of meeting. This is truly a wonderful association, something that I see growing from strength to strength into the next year and the year following that. And I believe there's so much more that I believe can come out of this association as we sort of move forward. So thank you so much for that.
Thank you, Mr. Pillai. Thank you, Mr. Sumaya. Well, indeed, it is a pleasure having them here. May I please request Mr. Karan Johar to say a few words?
Filmfare has always, I think, epitomized glamour in its own way and has, I think, the most tremendous legacy where it comes to not only publication houses, but also, I think, the legacy of cinema that it's always forged forward with. I think ever since Jitesh and his wonderful team have taken over the reins of Filmfare, it's not only provided, I think, great entertainment stories, great information about cinema, but has always pushed the fashion and glamour envelope and taken it to a larger level. I think this particular event, which Siroc has very graciously supported, I think has added to the repertoire and the grand legacy that Filmfare is so known for. Filmfare has vintage value, Filmfare has entertainment value, and now Filmfare has tremendous fashion and glamour value. I was deeply honored to share the page, or rather the folds, with so many illustrious ladies and gentlemen, some of them young, some legendary, and some of whom I've grown up watching and admired tremendously. Just being on the same page with them was a tremendous honor. And more than anything else, when friends come together, and I think today means a lot to all three of us, Jitesh and Manish are both very dear to me in different ways. And Manish and I, of course, have shared tremendous fashion, friendship, and film history together. And I think sharing the same platform with him is always a reminder of how important relationships are in the movie business, and sticking together is rare, but it is true. And Jitesh is one of the few members of the media that I have actually had a solid bond with over the years. And of course, a big thumbs up to the Times Group for constantly upping the ante and always doing something unusual. And thank you, Bhavesh, for constantly being such, a fashion reminder even in our zone. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Johar. Well, when we do talk about fashion and style, there's a name which we cannot miss at all. May I please request Mr. Manish Malhotra to say a few words?
Good evening, everyone. And as Karan said and Jitesh said, I think sharing a platform with close friends always feels and makes it more special. I think the change that Jitesh especially has got into Filmfare is that he's made it much more younger, more relevant of the times that prevail today. And I think that Filmfare is more fashionable and much more stylish today. Of course, it has, like Karan mentioned, it's a legendary magazine, the Legendary Awards. I always love the retrospect pictures that he puts up and which Filmfare always has in the last pages. In fact, I just flew in from Dubai, and I was even reading the Dubai edition, and it was I saw so many people on the flight going through the Filmfare Dubai edition. And I think today, style or well-being, looking good, feeling good is a part of all our lives. It's not just fashion. And when a magazine that is so historical with movies is also showing you and speaking about what is looking good today and what it means. So I think that's really great. And Siroc for coming in and hosting these fabulous awards. We were all there. It just seemed very intimate, seemed wonderful. And I think for all those people who think being stylish is just buying expensive clothes or living in couture, it's not true. It's also being, it's well-being. It's feeling beautiful to look beautiful. And that night I thought was a lot of fun night, and we all were so relaxed and enjoying it. So thank you, Filmfare, and thank you, Siroc.
Well, now's the moment that all of us are waiting for, we've gathered here for. So may I please request all of you all to unveil the Siroc Filmfare Glamour and Style Awards cover. We'll be right back.
Can me being part of Filmfare have the prerogative to ask you the first question? How fashion savvy, do you think the movies are getting? And is it an important part of the evolution of the movies?
Well, I think today's movies, Chitisha, more than fashion savvy, are getting a bit more real and very relevant of today's changing time. And I think the new fashion in movies is to be real. The small town girl has become the heroine. She's no more the glamazon girl who shops in New York. The small town boy who has dreams of making it big and does finally is your new hero. So I think in movies and costume design, it's all about what people wear. And I think that a certain sense of style has come in today's audience. I mean, they know what they want to wear, what they want to look like, what they want to see. So I think that's what the biggest change in movies in the last 3 to 4 years has been. And I think somewhere that started with Jab We Met, with Kareena's look of that salwar and t-shirt with a jacket. So that whole Western Indian, that the Indian cool kind of feel. Right.
Karan, ironically, while you gave fashion savvy to the movies, you came under constant criticism that you tend to cosmetize the movies and make it a little more glamorized than they should be, your movies. So how would you react to something like that?
I think that used to be a perception. I fought that perception for, I think, over a decade. But I wasn't apologetic about it. That was the path that I chose. I loved the fact that, cinema was a large-scale medium, and that opulence is something that I liked. Fashion is something I enjoyed. And being slightly over the top or far from the real zone was something that I believed in, and I wanted to pull it off with my own personal conviction. So, today, of course, one has to adapt to the syntax of the times. But at that point, I was like this boy who walked into the movie business with big dreamy eyes, and grown up on the works of Yash Chopra, the opulence of Raj Kapoor, the grandeur of their films and their vision. And I was very happy to emulate that vision and create my own zone along with their reverential memory. And that's what I think I did. And I'm very proud of the work I did even in that zone. And I continue to kind of feel that it's the important thing is to adapt to the time. So today, of course, maybe a Kabhi Khushi Kabhi Gham would not be able to be pulled off with that kind of conviction because the times have changed. And had I to do the same thing, I think there would be a large part of today's film cinegoer generation that wouldn't be able to identify. But those are the same people that still look back at that film on satellite when it does come and enjoys it for its vintage value, I think.
This question is directed to both of you. When you work together on a film, is there like a template that you follow, say, 3 things that you have to have or must do's, or we will absolutely, it's forbidden? Is there something that you'll work in tandem? How do you all work? Because you've collaborated on so many iconic films.
The thing is, honestly, when Karan and I actually met Karan through his dad and Sridevi, because I was designing for a film called Gumra, which his father was producing, and that's when I met Karan. I think that when Kuch Kuch Hota Hai was, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai started, it was like our film, like all of us, whether it was Shah Rukh or Kajol, that it never even occurred to me that, Karan's now becoming director. There was such happiness among all of us. And I think till date, I think for me, Karan's film is like my film, it's like my production, and I think like how I would, if I was producing that film, I would make sure that I'm on time, and that everything is done correctly. And likewise, when it's current film, I just make sure that everything is correct. So it's never that, you know. And of course, I think for any relationship which is personal and to last out professionally, it's really important that at your work, you don't get your personal equations. So it's not that when Karan's taking a shot, I'm going to just, you know, backslap him and say, hey, you know what, that happened last night. Because he's doing something really important at that time. So you've got to respect that. And I think, I don't know, I've never really understood why people say good friends can't work together. And I think Karan and me are an example. It's almost 20 years. And I mean, Karan's film starting now. We're all going to be in London for a long time. I'm actually looking forward to it. And yeah, so it's like my film starting. So I don't think of any kind of pressure.
No, I completely endorse what he said. I think when Manish does the clothes on my film, like, I'm completely stress-free. I think he and I have a complete understanding, you know. I think I completely respect his talent, his vision, and his extreme amount of hard work that he puts into every, even one single costume. Manish will give it a deep amount of thought. And I respect the fact that he's still so passionate after being in the business for nearly 25 years. He's still so passionate about every garment that he puts out there. And to me, that really, really strikes a chord on an emotional level. And working with him is like working with family. I mean, like, Manish and I have a complete understanding. Even when we kind of sit and jam on something, I mean, I trust him completely because he's more than being a fashion-friendly working entity. He's also passionate about Hindi cinema. And I think it's the synergy of the two that really makes him the man he is.
Members of the media?
Karan sir, yeah. Karan yeah. And Manish Malhotra, both, I have a question for you. That this year you have been awarded with this, Manish Malhotra, you have been awarded with the most glamorous designer and you have been awarded with the most stylish director, glamorous director. So what was your feeling and what do you think about this collaboration where fashion has been appreciated at a much more higher level?
Well, it's always important to platform fashion. It's a multi-billion dollar business worldwide. And I think that, you know, there's a certain perception sometimes, which is changing now completely, that fashion is frivolous. No. It's actually, as I said, a multi-billion dollar business in the world, and it's growing phenomenally today, even in our country. Manish is the leading mainstream designer of the country and the world, and he's to the point that when I produced a film called Humpty Sharma Ki Dulhania, there was a dialogue where we needed a leading designer name where she says, Lehenga pehnungi to sirf Manish Malhotra ki pehnungi, varna nahi karungi shadi. And he was the brand that the director wrote without any interference from me. And when I read that dialogue, I realized his reach is that large that if you go to even a small town or you go to a city that is not in the forefront of things, they will tell you that if you mention fashion designer, the recall is Manish Malhotra. So fashion is definitely on the map today, and proudly so. As far as the award, I think it's great that Filmfare has started this platform. Winning the most glamorous filmmaker is, of course, it's both, I would say, very extremely gratifying to know that, you know, someone thinks you're glamorous. Partially embarrassing as well, because glamorous can be, I think, such a subjective term in so many levels. But definitely, if somebody else had won it and not me, I would have been very upset. So winning is very critical, and winning any award for me is critical, be it glamour, be it director. I don't like to lose. If I'm nominated with five other names, I'd like to win.
Manish, please say your thoughts also.
Well, I think when a professional gets an award like this, it's of course about first their work, I would think. You know, their work has to be what you are being awarded for. So I think my work has been glamorous. I think in my mind, glamour, style, fashion, it's all very related. And, you know, you don't necessarily have to be fashionable, but you could be very stylish. And the way you carry even a simple cotton shirt could be really glamorous. You know, so that's what I think. So the and I think that what's great here is that Filmfare, being a film magazine in the last few years has really, you know, in fact, earlier I used to make fun of Jitesh. I said, oh, so much of fashion. But today, when I saw this in the flight while coming from Dubai, and I've been noticing that so many people are looking, who love movies, look at Filmfare for what fashion and style can be. So I think them to take that step further and expand their spectrum, I think it's great. And somewhere we all need to do that. And I think that's really brilliant. And I felt very good getting the award. You always feel good getting the awards, and the next day you move on and you start working. But of course, this was special because it was the first. So I'm very happy to win the first Glamour and Style Awards by Filmfare.
Okay, Karan sir, please allow me to ask. Karan sir, please allow me to ask that what's your current status of the most awaited project, two of your projects, Ram Lakhan and Shuddhi, please.
They're both awaited by us also. we are also awaiting it. Shuddhi should we definitely go on the floors very soon. The pre-production on that film is a tumultuous task because it's a very widespread film with a large scale, so it needs a lot of time. And Karan Malhotra, the film, is releasing Brothers in August, so he'll get into it right after that. Ram Lakhan should start early 2016. Rohit Shetty is all set. As soon as he finishes his already announced film Dilwale, we will, in the next 2 months, announce the cast. And just to go on record and say the film has not been cast, because every morning I open some newspaper or read some online news that suggests a new cast for Ram Lakhan. Eventually, I think I will be playing Ram and Rohit will be playing Lakhan, because that's the way it's going. Every day there's a new information about that film. So I always say, till we go on record, till Rohit and I don't go on record, that film hasn't been cast. But it's all set to start 2016, early 2016.
But Karan, I think the best thing about Shuddhi and Ram Lakhan is that they haven't even been casted, but they are the most written about films, I think, in the last 1 year.
Yeah, well.
And the most awaited.
Yeah. Well, there's only that much I think we can pull it off till we better get on the floors and release it finally.
All right. Karan, right here.
Yeah.
Straight. Right,
yeah.
Talking about style and glamour, obviously your look in Bombay Velvet has been, you know, everybody has been talking about it. It's extremely smart. So who really styled you, and tell us more about it? What really went into putting it on?
I had nothing to do with the styling of that film. I had nothing to do with that film at all, actually. I just reported as an actor and I forgot that I was a filmmaker or had any perception or any point of view. It was styled by Niharika. And it was conceptualized by Anurag in tandem with Niharika. They wanted me to look very different for myself. And it's also a film based in the 60s, so it had to have a certain retro element in its styling. But the character is partially flamboyant, so there is a certain usage of color and within the, which I don't normally wear. I wear a lot of black. And I've worn all kinds of colors. And I just kept my mouth shut because I felt as an actor, I can't have a perspective. I have to follow the vision of the filmmaker because that's what I want out of actors myself. So if I start throwing my own tantrum on the side, it won't go. And Anurag is something you can't throw a tantrum with because he has a very clear vision. I'm really nervous about it because it's my first foray into film acting, and I'm just really stressed out about how it's going to be accepted when it's out.
All right. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, I have to butt here and say Karan plays this lean mean machine, so that's your scoop. And those who have sneak peeked it say they couldn't believe that Karan could have played mean with so much aplomb. So he's really mean.
I'm not mean. Like when somebody asks me like, oh, you're playing a villain, and I have to like correct them and say, I'm not like Mogambo or anything like that. Like, you know, it's like, it's not that kind of villain. It's a little bit of it's a gray character which ventures into the black once in a while. But that's Anurag's film, so everybody's doing the same actually in this film.
Right. Karan, since you are a filmmaker, there's a question I have to ask you. Recently, the CBFC, another film called Unfreedom, has been banned by the CBFC, saying it's got too much of homosexual content and it can't really, you know, go on the big screen. So as a filmmaker, do you think banning is an option, or, you know, like, is it justified?
I don't think banning anything is something that I endorse. I also feel we've been in very detailed and very productive talks with the authorities to be on censorship. I do believe very strongly there should be certification, not censorship. And it's something that I actually have been trying to suggest for a while. Just like the British Film Board of certification has like a 12, a PG, a 15, an 18. We all hope that perhaps we can, and the right people are handling the situation, so I wouldn't want to comment while the process is still on. I just have to say that the industry, the fraternity, have come together to kind of resolve the crisis that seems to surround this particular issue, and I hope very soon that we will have an amicable solution to it all.
Hi, Karan. Hi.
Hi.
I just want to know, in today's time, do you think which hero or heroine is perfect in fashion or style in industry?
Manish should actually answer that because.
No, I would like to take the answer from both.
who I think is the most stylish. I definitely think that Sonam is a game changer when it comes to red carpet fashion. I do believe that she should be given that credit completely because I think she revolutionized the concept of red carpet fashion, and she started the ball rolling and everyone rolled along. So I definitely think she pioneered that. And also there was a sudden burst of stylists, and I know she housed a few of them, and Rhea, her sister, is definitely a large part of that process as well. So she should be given due credit for it as well. I would say Sonam is definitely one of the most fashionable women in the business. When it comes to fashion iconic in general, I don't think there's anyone better than Mr. Bachchan. I think you can give him anything to wear and he carries it off with the aplomb that I don't think any other individual has. Manish has styled him on two of the films that I've directed with him, and he would endorse that, I'm sure, that you, from giving him the bright red coat to a fur coat to a anything overtly opulent to something completely simple and basic, he can pull off almost anything and pull it off with the fashion of a legend.
Thank you.
But I think generally what happens is that when you see people wearing very fashionable clothes and clothes that are out there, you kind of always feel, okay, that's, you know, that's a very fashionable person. But I think it has to be you and not borrowed. And I think especially in a superstar like Mr. Bachchan, who has with time changed and carried those clothes and felt good in them and looked good. When it comes to Sonam, she again feels good in what she wears. I mean, if somebody else had to, you know, do what she does, probably not carry it that well. And so it wouldn't, you know, look that good. So I think that, I think it's very, very important. I mean, when I see Ranveer Singh and he wears those really quirky suits, and I always wonder, I always keep looking at him and thinking that which other actor can carry that?
Yeah.
But I think it's his personality that helps him carry
and
that.
And your friend Kangana, I mean,
yeah, and Kangana again is, I think, I actually credit a lot to Kangana because, I mean, coming from a small town and learning everything here and evolving and understanding fashion and carrying it off so well, I think is... I don't know why Kangana is saying this, but yes.
No, I'm just saying that because I do believe Kangana has the quirkiest and the most individualistic sense of fashion.
Yeah.
I think she has her own sense, and I think she is not somebody who follows the norm. She sets them.
Thank you.
Fantastic. So members of the media, before we leave, the last thoughts before we leave, at least the thoughts that I have are, a Karan Johar film and a Manish Malhotra design will never be out of style. Thank you so much for being with us. It was a fabulous evening.
Thank you.